Hello and welcome to this fourth Open Bootloader presentation, where I will show you how to add support for the A2C interface. We will start with the prerequisites required to go through that video. Then, I will show you the code change overview required to add to the Open Bootloader the support for the A2C interface. Before going into further details, it is recommended to have seen the first three parts of this video series. It is expected to have Open Bootloader running on your demonstration board. To reproduce the same example, you will need to have installed STM32CubeID. Finally, this video was done based on the Nucleo G474i, but can be easily tailored to other STM32 G4 demonstration boards. In order for Open Bootloader to support the A2C interface, we'll have to go through the following operation. First, we'll have to copy the A2C interface.c and A2C interface.h available in the interfaces patterns A2C directory to the repository Open Bootloader target. Then, we'll have to add files to our project, openbl A2C command.c and openbl A2C command.h from the directory modules A2C. Then we'll have to configure the A2C interface in interfaces _conf. We'll start by adding the A2C interface.c and A2C interface.h file. We'll copy the A2C interface.c and A2C interface.h from the middleware in directory Open Bootloader interfaces patterns A2C. We will add it to our project. We'll then add the openbl A2C cmd.c and openbl A2C cmd.h to the module directories to our project. We right click on Open Bootloader project properties in C++ grid settings in the tool settings tab in the section MCU GCC compiler input path. We'll add the directory path to our A2C modules directory. So, like that. We click on apply, apply and close. In interfaces conf, we'll add informations for our A2C peripheral information. So we'll go to interfaces conf and we'll add definitions for our A2C interface. We are going to choose the A2C peripheral tool and then for the A2C peripheral tool, for STL, we are going to choose the PA9. For SDA, we are going to choose PA8. A2C slave address, we'll choose 8-bit definition BA, for example. STM32 G474QETX flash.md. We will add definition in the data section for RAM file. In A2C interface.h, we will add a constant definition for RAM file. In A2C interface, we'll simplify the reader. don't need the flash interface.h here. And then because we are using I2C2 on GPIO A bank, we'll use the GPIO A clock and I2C2 instead of I2C1. We are now going to edit the app openbootloader.c in openbootloader app and add references to the I2C interface. We are first going to add an include for the I2C interface.h. Then we'll have an include for the openbl I2C cmd.h. Then we will define an I2C handle. So and I2C ops structure. In the open bootloader init function, a reference to the I2C interface. In flash interface.h, we will add send busy byte func and openbl enable busy state sending. In flash interface.c, we will add openbl enable busy state sending definition. We'll need to copy the directory module I2C in the ST open bootloader modules for our project. And then in driver STM32G4XXHAL driver, I2C copy file STM32G4XXLL-I2C.c and reference it in the project. In file platform.h, add include STM32G4XXLL-I2C.h. We can now build our project. Once Open Bootloader is successfully generated, we can now load it. Free run. Thank you.